Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds with another spring warbler warm-up video, and this one is going to cover yellow-throated warbler. A quick note, common yellow-throat and yellow-throated warbler are two different warbler species, this video covering the latter. Common yellow-throat looks like this, and sometimes you'll hear them called common yellow-throated warbler, kind of conflating the two names, but that just gets a little bit confusing and goes against the official names of the species, so I would strongly recommend against doing that. And back to yellow-throated warbler, they're just absolutely striking birds. They're just gorgeous and one of my personal favorite species. Of course, they have a bright yellow throat and often a touch of yellow here kind of at the front of the eyebrow. And then the rest of the bird is primarily white and black, with the exception of just kind of this gray color in the back and the nape and the crown. And for the facial pattern, you'll notice a bold white eyebrow and a white patch here along the side of the neck. And that kind of offsets a sort of triangular-shaped black patch in the cheek, which extends down towards the body and frames the yellow throat. And there's also a white arc underneath the eye. And then on the body, you have just white with some black streaking down the sides. And then on the undertail, you have white. So just overall, really, really refined looking birds. And if we compare to yellow-rumped warbler, eastern yellow-rumps don't have yellow throats, but rather have yellow shoulder patches and sometimes crown. And of course, they have a yellow rump as well. The western Audubon subspecies do have yellow throats, but they do have the rest of these features as well. So the shoulder patches especially would be a good way to rule out yellow-throated warbler on something like this. And then Magnolia warbler. Magnolias have a much more extensively yellow body, and they have more streaking towards the middle of the chest as well, and kind of this dark collar. And they also have their distinctive two-color tail with white base and extensive black tip, and that's a diagnostic tail pattern for Magnolia warbler year-round. And then if we look at Blackburnian warbler, Blackburnian warblers oftentimes will have a much more orange color compared to yellow-throated warbler, and they have a lot more of the orange in the face as well. You can see like the eyebrow and even back here behind the cheek. And then the back color is also darker, and they have kind of the pale braces. And even on this bird, which is a lot more towards the yellow end compared to like the breeding plumage males in the spring, you can still see that the color is a lot more towards the orange end compared to yellow-throated warbler. But I have seen those two species confused before, so just be careful there. And if you found this helpful, please like and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.